For today I may have opinion and I may leave it tomorrow. Tomorrow I may have an opinion and I may leave it the day after. So Abu Hanifa, may Allah have mercy be on him, rahimahullah, he discouraged people writing his opinion. Unless it was a unanimous ijma amongst all the scholars, amongst all the students, then he gave permission. Otherwise, he did not like people writing his opinions. And according to one of his students, Zufar, he says that Imam Shafi, he said that we should be careful. The opinion, we are human beings, we make mistakes. What opinion I have today, he said, according to the student Zufar of Imam Abu Hanifa, that I forbid people to pass opinions without proof based on my opinion. Abu Hanifa said that I forbid people to pass opinions, to make judgments without analyzing my proof. I forbid those people without analyzing my proof to pass the opinion on my statements. That means unless you don't know the proofs, you do not give opinion on my statement. He forbid those people. The fourth Aimmah, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal also was of the same opinion. He was so strict that Abu Hanifa, Imam Abu Hanifa, he said, don't write my opinion unless it is confirmed, unless there is an ijma. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal was more strict because taqleed started. He said, don't write any of my opinions. If you find any of my opinion, whether it be for Imam Malik, or my opinion on Imam Malik, or Imam Shafi, Imam Abu Hanifa, go to the source. And if you find any of my opinion which goes against the opinion of Allah and His Rasul, you reject my opinion. That's the reason I say I am 100% humbly. If humbly means a person who follows the teachings of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, I am 100% humbly. Other people are 70%, 80%. So in teachings, if you say following the teachings of Abu Hanifa, Imam Abu Hanifa, may Allah's mercy be on him, makes you a Hanafi, I am a Pakka Hanafi, 100% Hanafi. If following the teachings of Imam Malik makes you a Maliki, I am a 100% Maliki. If following the teachings of Imam Shafi makes you a Shafi, I am a 100% Shafi. If following the teachings of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal makes you a humbly, I am a 100% Saufisad humbly. Because all these four great Aimmah said, if you find any of my fatwa which goes against Allah and His Rasul, you throw my fatwa on the wall. See, all the madhabs of all these four great Aimmahs was what? What is the meaning of madhab? Madhab means way of going or time of going. Another word for madhab is sunnah. Even sunnah means way. Sunnah of the Prophet means way of the Prophet. So all the madhabs of all these four Aimmahs was the madhab of the Rasul. All the Aimmahs said, if you find a Sahih Hadith, you reject my opinion. That means all the four Aimmahs, their madhab was the madhab of the Rasul. Simple. The way of the Rasul. Imam Abu Hanifa, may Allah be pleased with him, may Allah's mercy be on him, he never came to start a new Hanafi madhab. Imam Malik never came to start a new Maliki madhab. Imam Shafi never came to start a Shafi madhab. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal never came to start a new Hanbali madhab. All of them followed the madhab of the Rasul. Like how the Christians misunderstand Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, never came to teach Christianity. He came to teach Islam. Similarly, all these four great Aimmahs, they came to give us knowledge of the teachings of Allah and His Rasul. Their madhab was no madhab but the madhab of the Rasul. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 4, verse number 59, Atiullah, Atiur Rasul, obey Allah and obey the Messenger, and those charged with affairs. With those charged with affairs or with knowledge. You have to follow Allah and His Rasul. After that Allah says, and those who are charged with the affairs, those endowed with knowledge. But the verse does not end there. The verse continues. But if they differ, go back to Allah and His Rasul. So if those with knowledge, Imam Shafi, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Imam Malik, Imam Hanbal, may Allah's mercy be on them all. If they differ, go back to Allah and His Rasul. So all the four Aimmas, they said the same thing. If you find my fatwa which goes against Allah and His Rasul, reject my opinion. Same thing Allah says, Atullah, Atul Rasul, obey Allah and obey the messengers, and those charged with their faith, those endowed with knowledge. But if they differ, go back to Allah and His Rasul if you believe in Allah and the last day. For this is the best and the correct way of determination. There is no better way of determination according to Allah than going back to Allah and His Rasul. It is so simple. Now, there are some brothers who come and ask me the question. Brother Zakir, fine. Those people who have knowledge of Quran and Hadith, for them it is very easy to know what is right, what is wrong, what is Sahih Hadith, what is Zaif Hadith. How can we, as lay Muslims, as common Muslims, understand what is right? You should call yourself only, even in the previous Hadith of Tirmidhi, it ends by saying, if you call anything besides the way of the Allah, what Allah has called you, and He says, Muslim, Mu'min, and Abdullah. A Muslim, a believer, and the worship of Allah. If you call anything besides these three things to yourself, you're calling yourself to hellfire. Hadith. This Salaf, Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah quotes, that if you call anything, I don't know which thing should I thank more for Allah, for bringing me Islam, or for keeping me away from the innovators. You cannot call anything besides what Allah has called you in the Quran, Muslim, Mu'min, and Abdullah. Instead of Muhammad is Muslim. Therefore I say, Atiullah, Atiullah. Therefore I, for label, I prefer calling myself Muslim. That's it. First a Muslim, last a Muslim. I am not hurting any of my Muslim brothers, whether it's a Hanafi or a Shafi or a Hanbali or a Maliki or a Ahle Hadith or a Salafi. Believe me, I love all. I love all my Muslim brothers. I am not here to hurt anyone's feeling. Therefore, I said, Ta'ala vila kalmitin sawa im bainana bainakum. Come to common terms as between us and you. I am coming to common terms. I respect Abu Hanifa, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Ahmad Hanbal, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi. I respect the great scholars of this. I respect the Salafi Salihin. I follow them. Alhamdulillah. Therefore, first the Muslim, last the Muslim. Now, one of the second reasons for the disunity is Alhamdulillah, mashallah. You don't have the time, yet you can. That's not called taqleed. But if someone shows you proof against the scholar you respect, and yet you follow him blindly, that is taqleed. The taqleed we can only do is of Allah and His Rasul. Bas. Atiullah, Atiur Rasul, bas. No one else. Simple. Simple formula. Now some people come and tell me, Brother Zakir, you talk, said, don't make sect. But didn't the Prophet said, there will be 73 sects? I said, yes. The Prophet said, there will be. Prophet didn't say you should make. Allah says, don't make. But Prophet knew, even though Allah says, don't make sects, the Muslims are bound to make. So he predicted there will be. He didn't say you should make. And if you read the Sahih Hadith of Abu Dawud, Hadith number 4579 and Hadith number 4580, it says that Prophet Muhammad said that the Jews were divided into 71 or 72 sects, the Christians were divided into 71 or 72 sects, and the Muslims will be divided into 73 sects